Congresswoman Marjorie Greene has been booted from the House Freedom Caucus, the far right group of Republicans who you would think Marjorie Greene would fit right in with. However, her latest tiff with Lauren Boebert played into the decision here, but there is a twist to the story, so stick around for that. First, the details. So apparently the final straw was her big fight with Lauren Boebert on the House floor. They both wanted to introduce impeachment proposals against Joe Biden. Marjorie Greene was gonna move forward with her proposal, and then that got squashed because Lauren Boebert forced a vote on her proposal. Anyway, it led to a conflict between the two on the House floor in which Marjorie Greene referred to Lauren Boebert as a little bitch. And apparently that is an unprofessional act in a professional setting. I would venture to say that if Cenk called me a little bitch or vice versa, it probably wouldn't play so well. And so they didn't like it on the House floor either. Greene is no longer with the House Freedom Caucus, a Republican lawmaker told the Daily Beast, noting that disparaging fellow members is frowned upon. I think there has been some disparagement, and that's been going on, the GOP lawmaker added. Representative Andy Harris agreed, saying, I think the way she referred to a fellow member was probably not the way we expect our members to refer to other fellow, especially female members. And I'm gonna give you the twist to the story in just a minute, but before I do, Cenk, you know, you're not really a giant fan of civility politics.
No, I'm not. And so this is a fun, interesting story, because I'm gonna show you all the different ways that Marjorie Taylor Greene and Lauren Boebert were right in this story.
Mm.
Okay, and then who's the final victor in terms of who's most right about Marjorie Taylor Greene getting kicked off? I'll save that to the end. So first, Marjorie Taylor Greene was correct when she said that she had introduced a bill earlier that essentially did the same thing as Boebert's bill. And so Boebert was kind of trying to steal her spotlight to some degree by introducing the same bill or a very similar bill. So Marjorie Taylor Greene is correct about that. Hold. I'll tell you what Boebert's right about.
No, I was just gonna comment about how spotlight is the perfect word to use here because it's all theater.
Yes.
It's all theater.
So yeah. So now Boebert says, yeah, okay, maybe there were similar bills, but I use the procedure that would have us vote on my bill right away because I think you're sitting on your bill because McCarthy told you to.
Mm.
And Boebert is correct, that is what is happening. So Marjorie Taylor Greene doesn't actually wanna push that bill, she said earlier, because she has a deal with McCarthy. Mm. She huffs and puffs about how, impeachment and we need to do it, and I said it from day one before I knew any facts, I'm dumber than her, okay? Congrats, but in this case, if you wanted to really push it forward, you would have used the same procedure Lauren Boebert did, and you're definitely not doing that. So Boebert is correct about that. Now, is that the right time to push that? And there was a number of issues at the same time, and it would have perhaps caused us to default on our debt ceiling and destroy the global economy. Well, that's a bad idea by Boebert. So Marjorie Taylor Greene is correct on the policy, okay? Now, should I get to the ending of who's right about this?
Well, I gotta give them the little twisty twist,
okay?
You can't step on my lines here.
All right.
I've been excited to share this with you guys.
Okay.
So apparently, Representative Boebert did not want Marjorie Greene kicked out of the House Freedom Caucus. So here is the reporting on that. During internal deliberations, writes the Daily Beast, almost 2 weeks ago, Boebert agreed with another member who argued against removing Greene out of respect for her right to freedom of speech. She was against having her removed. A GOP lawmaker familiar with the House Freedom Caucus meeting told the Daily Beast she was actually against it. And then Boebert confirmed to the Daily Beast that she defended Greene on freedom of speech grounds, but would not comment on how she ultimately voted, which I think is strange, that very last part. So that makes me think, did she vote in favor of kicking her out? Even though she
you did. Know. So she doesn't say, but I can tell you why she did, okay?
What a little bitch.
Yeah. So you can tell that she voted her out because she said, that's not the reason I used in my vote. In other words, yeah, I voted against her, but not because of the speech issue, but because of the fact that she doesn't agree with us anymore problem, okay? So can I adjudicate now?
Go ahead.
Okay, in this one, Boebert is correct. So why? Well, this whole, oh, she called me a little bitch. So what? Okay, you guys call each other and other people those kind of words all the time, 24/7. I mean, each other behind the scenes, right? That one was just happened to be in front of the scenes. For the rest of us, you call us the worst kind of names 24/7. All of a sudden, the House Freedom Caucus cares about decorum? The caucus that supports Donald the monster Trump the most, who breaks every etiquette, every rule, every decorum, all of a sudden they're like, oh, I do declare someone has been called a little bitch. Okay, well, what shall we do? Our knickers are in a bunch. No, 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 that's a nonsense reason. And I believe, I halfway believe Boebert saying she didn't vote based on that, and then she defended her on that. And it makes sense, because if you're Boebert, you don't want to get thrown out of the caucus for saying insults about other people, because that's what she does 24/7. And so it's self-preservation, but also logical and correct in my opinion, okay? But she did vote, in my, based on the reasons I just gave you, she did seem to vote against Marjorie Taylor Greene. Mm-hmm. Is she also right about that? Yes, she's also right about that. Why?
What?
Not because Marjorie Taylor Greene shouldn't be kicked out for language. That's hilarious. But she fundamentally doesn't agree with the Freedom Caucus anymore. And so it's not because Marjorie Taylor Greene isn't radical. She is. She's radical in different ways, but she's chosen a strategy that is different than the Freedom Caucus.
By the way, I just have to comment on how surprising that is.
Yeah.
Okay, people aren't gonna like what I'm gonna say, but it's the truth, and try to acknowledge the truth. You have Marjorie Greene, who on every level seems to be unhinged, but she has appeared to allow herself to think strategically, politically speaking. I mean, I don't agree with her on anything, but nonetheless, she's thinking strategically. I wanna know what the strategic thinking is among progressives in Congress.
So that's exactly where I was going, Anna. Okay, so the Freedom Caucus's strategy is, no, we obstruct and we vote no, and we challenge establishment Republicans to go further right. And we hold the line for as long as humanly possible until they almost meet us all the way, right? And the idiot Democrats are useless. So we were basically just arguing with within the party, because whatever Republicans want, Republicans always get, right? And wait, why are the Democrats useless? Why don't the Democrats ever get anything they want? Because the corporate Democrats largely agree with the corporate Republicans. They're like, oh, you want to cut from the average man and give taxes for the rich, and we're pretending that we're doing this over the debt ceiling. Golly gee, no, don't do that, right? They don't have to negotiate at all. They do it on purpose. And mainstream media then comes in and lies for them and goes, oh, they had to do it, you don't know, they had to do it. No, it's okay. So that's a longer story. But here the Progressive Caucus could be super helpful. Progressive Caucus can hold a line, especially when Democrats are in charge, but sometimes in a mixed Congress. And they could say, they could do the same thing the Freedom Caucus does. No, we're holding the line. You gotta come towards us. You gotta give me at least $15 minimum wage. I would have, if I was in the caucus, I would have demanded $15 minimum wage and paid family leave. Guys, you can't pull like the fake left thing where you're like, oh, I demand everything. If you don't give me everything, I vote no all the time. Well, then your threats are useless and you've lost your leverage. Mm-hmm. You have to use your leverage to get specific dual bills passed at that moment. But progressives don't understand. I'm sorry, sorry progressives in Congress, but you don't understand politics at all. So you're like, oh, what do? We give away our power. Right away, we say, trust Biden, right? And just give all of our power to Biden. And then he screws us and gives Manchin the Mountain Valley Pipeline, even though Manchin's been punching him in the face the entire time he's been president, right? So progressives, just sorry, get a better leader, understand politics, do way better. Because strategically, the lunatics of the Freedom Caucus are routing you.
Final thing I'll say about this is, look, they have booted Marjorie Greene from their caucus. And it's interesting because when you look at the Progressive Caucus, it is full to the brim of normal corporate Democrats.
Two-thirds of them.
So what's the litmus test here to be part of that caucus? And I just think, listen, we all see what's going on here. We see who's included in that caucus. There isn't safety in numbers in this situation. You need to have some form of accountability and ensure that the people who are part of this caucus are actually genuinely on board for the same fight for the same policies. And I just don't see that right now with the Progressive
Caucus. I've got to say two last things. One is on the left side. Look, if I was in Congress, I would have started the Justice Caucus and I would have taken the actual progressives and said, hey, we're going to vote as a block, guys. Of course, if they agree, right? And they agree, like, oh, yeah, that strategy makes sense, right? Can't force anyone to do anything. But hey, if we hold a line, here's the results. Here, I'll do proof of concept. Let's do it on $15 minimum wage and see how it goes. And if I'm wrong, then vote against me next time. But I'm not going to be wrong. They're going to give it to us, okay? So, but unfortunately, our progressives in Congress believe that the most important rule in the world is respecting and kissing the ass of their fellow Democratic colleagues who are corrupt and take corporate money and do corporate wishes. And they think fighting back is so wrong. It's so wrong. Don't do it. It's impolite. Mainstream media is going to yell at us. Am I making fun of progressives in Congress that I helped to get elected? Yes, I am. Do better. Do way better. Now, finally, back to the Freedom Caucus. Why do I say Boebert is correct strategically? Of course, they're not right on policy on any of this stuff, right? They're 200% wrong on policy. But the Freedom Caucus is supposed to hold the line, and Marjorie Taylor Greene is not holding the line. She's agreeing with Kevin McCarthy, and she's helping Kevin McCarthy pass the debt ceiling and all these things that the Freedom Caucus doesn't want. So the correct political strategy is to kick her out and say, no, this is a caucus for people who want to hold the line in their case for extreme right-wing values, okay? And you don't want to do that anymore, so you got to go. And that is super fair. If there was a Justice Caucus and they did hold a line, it would work politically. The Freedom Caucus has done it 200 times. You don't have eyes? You can't see them doing it effectively and pulling the whole Overton window to the right? You can't see that? No, you're just not trying hard enough if you're in progressives in Congress.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.